So is this going to air in the morning?
It's going to air on a nationally syndicated program all over the place, and even airs in Canada. Well, I can see you're a real morning person. You like getting up in the morning,
don't
you?
Oh, I love mornings, yes.
You don't really even like to sleep, do you?
Oh, no, not at all.
Because your schedule seems to push it where you don't include sleeping in your schedule.
Well, I figure I peaked at 25, and now I'm trying to include it a little more, you know, on the slide towards 50.
Like, you're really now, you're 14 years old now, and you look like you're 26, right?
Right, exactly. Yeah.
All right.
I feel like I'm 90.
You're a Canadian young man.
Yes, I am.
But American now, but you're still Canadian at heart. In elementary school, you have report cards, right? Where you
right.
get A's and B's and C's and that kind of thing. I want you to give yourself grades in the following subjects.
Oh, jeez.
All right, here we go. Getting along with others.
B.
Okay, that's fair. Money management.
Well, I give myself a D in that, but I give myself an A in hiring.
Okay. Relationships with women.
B.
That's pretty high. Music.
Doing okay. Music, what, appreciation or execution?
Execution.
C plus.
Mm. Math.
D.
English.
E. A.
Right. Spelling.
B plus.
Effort. In life.
A, I guess.
You try real hard. Conduct.
Before noon, a D. After noon, but a B.
Remember the comment section? Where they used to have to, teachers would write
yes,
little sentences about you, would they?
Michael is a prime candidate for incarceration. They were pretty good to me. Actually, they were kind of optimistic until about the ninth grade, and then it kind of tapered off. But actually pretty encouraging. He usually said Michael would concentrate a little bit more.
Mm-hmm. What were you thinking about?
I don't know. Probably usually, at that age, probably hockey.
Mm-hmm. Were you a good kid in class? I mean, were you sitting in the front of the class paying attention to the teacher, or were you sitting in the back cutting up, or in the middle somewhere?
I think I probably found a way to do both, mm-hmm. you know, kind of sit up at the front and be a good guy, and then as soon as the teacher went down to get the attendance sheets from the office, I usually kind of took over.
How were your parents when you were young? Did y'all get along real well? You good boy, good
yeah.
son?
Well, I don't know about that, you know.
I mean, all kids
we're all
have a hard time with you.
But yeah, but no, I have a great relationship with my folks. I always did. Mm-hmm. You know, my father was in the military, and a certain amount of discipline, you know, so got along well.
Tell me about getting along with fans. You're very well known now, obviously, with television and film success and everything you're doing. How do you handle the autographs and the screaming and that kind of thing? Do you have a philosophy about it?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, philosophy is just essentially, I mean, what an amazing privilege. You know, it's not, you know, people like to kind of build up this image of this army of 14-year-old girls that want to tear you apart, and it really isn't like that. I mean, people, as a rule, are real polite and real courteous, mm-hmm. and essentially, you know, I find myself in the situation of going to cities that I've never been to and having friends, and like I said, you know, that's an amazing privilege.
Do you ever feel isolated? That feeling of, you know, I shouldn't go outside, but you all make it up in your head?
Well, you know, not really. I mean, you know, in Los Angeles especially, because it's an industry town that, you know, I essentially move around like anybody else. I think you get into the Midwest and other parts of the States, and, you know, it's a judgment call in terms of what you want to get done. I mean, if you want to go out and accomplish a whole bunch of things in a very short amount of time, it's tough to do. But, no, I don't try to isolate myself too much or try and protect myself too much from a threat that I don't really perceive as being there, you know?
Do you sometimes think your life is moving too fast? Or is
only,
it slowed down
only,
something?
Only this morning. no, I think I got a real grip on what's going on. You know, you make a decision to make a career out of being an actor. Mm-hmm. You kind of brace yourself for a good deal of unemployment. So when you find yourself in the situation where you have a good deal of employment, I think you just buck up and you know and take advantage of it, do the best work you can do, and kind of know that you know maybe 10 years down the line, you know you'll be what kids watch when they come home from school, and you know syndicated television we're talking about, and you know so I'm essentially feeling good about. the pace that I'm setting and the work that I'm doing.
One thing I'm thinking about with you in music, because I keep seeing you with a guitar a lot, are you and Don Johnson and Bruce Willis going to have the Primetime band?
No, I think Don and Bruce, you know, had kind of professional music careers before they got into acting. I mean, it was always just a hobby with me. Mm-hmm. And, I mentioned a couple times yesterday, you know, much to the embarrassment of the music industry, I have been offered deals, but it's not...
it's an exploit, what you feel, though?
Yeah, you know, I wouldn't really feel good about asking somebody to pay $9 for that. You know, I have a career and it takes all my attention, and I feel that anything else would pretty much be exploitive and really much for, to achieve the ultimate end of fattening my bank account.
But it's still a lot of fun, isn't it? It's great getting
to play, and especially to play in the context of a film. You know, is great. I mean, I love playing a musician. Mm-hmm. You know. But to pass myself off as a musician, as Michael Fox, is something that...
And a last little bit of business. Back to the Future was such a big success, and it seemed to lend itself to a sequel at the end, but I haven't really heard any more about that. What's going on?
Well, it's definitely in the works. I mean, everybody's all signed up for it. Bob Zemeckis, who directed Back to the Future, is doing another film right now, mm-hmm. called Who Killed Roger Rabbit? So when he finishes that, we're going to go, I think it's in 88.
Okay, so you've got to really, it'll be a year and
it'll
a half
be like
before we see it.
Before it's in the theaters, yeah.
Okay, so I wondered about that. Well, you're doing wonderfully.
To the
and family ties, are you still going to stay with that a little more?
I'm with that until they pull
until
the plug,
it's over.
Which doesn't look like it's going to happen. So.
So you'll be part of that family when you're old and gray, right?
You bet. I'm trucking away. I'm old and gray right now, actually.
All right, well, thank you a lot.
Thank you.
Wonderful actor, and we enjoy your work a lot.
Thank you. Hello, Nashville.
All right, thank you. All right, wonderful. No, I was in a garage, but that's impossible. Applause? Is that what he said? Oh. All right, where am I supposed to look? How about over here? Okay. All right. I'm just going to look in. Okay. Don't you love to be stared at?